Pastor Sherwood Hamilton of the House of Prayer, located in Darlington, South Carolina, on 1349 Rogers Road. I'd like to invite you to all of our services held Friday night at 8 p.m. and on Saturday at 10:30 a.m. as well as 3 p.m. You are invited to come with us to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. We are people that are striving to serve the Lord to the fullest, for we believe that we are in the last days. We are people that believe every word of God, because every word of God has been inspired by the Spirit of the Lord. In Mark 9 and 7, we find these words here.
And there was a cloud that overshadowed them, and a voice came out of the cloud saying, "This is my beloved Son, hear him."
This is my beloved Son, hear him. These were the words of the Father to all of those that was there, and these same words apply to us today. Hear the words of Christ Jesus. Why must we hear these words? John 12 and 49 tells us.
For I have not spoken of myself, but the Father which sent me, he gave me a commandment, what I should say and what I should speak.
What I should say and what I should speak. Everything that Christ has mentioned, amen, he got it directly from the Father. And one of the incredible things that the Father commanded Christ to say that still applies today in 2017 can be found in Matthew 4 and verse 4.
And he answered and said, "It is written, man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God."
Every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God, that is what you and I supposed to live by. Now, if you call yourself a Christian, if you proclaim to be a saint of the Most High God, then this is your requirement. This is a commandment from the Father. You must do this. If you fail to do this, then the Lord told Christ to say these words to you as well as unto I. Luke 6 and verse 46.
"And why call ye me Lord, Lord, and do not the things which I say?"
Why call me Lord, Lord, and do not the things that I say. Amen. So pray for us as we pray for you, that we both, 2 Peter 3:18, that we both fulfill this scripture. Amen. Praise God, because the Lord wants you and I both to be found worthy, amen, to be in his kingdom, which is going to set upon this earth. So remember us in prayer if you cannot make it to the service, as we continue to pray your strength in the Lord. And we both pray in this prayer right here, 2 Peter 3:18.
"But grow in grace."
Grow in grace.
"And in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ."
And in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
"To him be glory both now and forever." Amen.
To him be the glory. To him be the glory both now and forever. Amen. Bring me to Revelation chapter 3. As we continue the message, there is a place of safety for God's people. Revelation 3 and 10.
"Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth."
The Lord has left a promise to the people that are willing to keep his word. As the scripture says, "Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation." Amen. Praise God. "Which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell on the earth." There's our temptation. As we said in the previous broadcast, amen, it's something that it was unlike any event has ever taken place on the earth. And you and I both, amen, want to be in that place of safety that God is going to provide for us. Now, do not be deceived into thinking that you're going to be raptured out of here before the great tribulation occurs, because that will not happen. Some people convert to the verse found in 1 Thessalonians 4 and 17 as proof that we will escape the great tribulation, amen, by way of rapture. But very quickly, let's look at that verse and let's see if Apostle Paul is telling the believers in his day, amen, that they were going to be raptured out of here, amen, before the great tribulation. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 17.
"Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord.
As Paul began to explain to them about the resurrection, he did not mention anything about the great tribulation.
Amen.
He's simply talking about the greatest event for the people of God, and that is to be changed from mortal to immortality.
Amen.
From taking putting off this old corruptible body and putting on an incorruptible body.
Amen.
He is not talking about God snatching us out of here before the great tribulation. One of the problems with the rapture whole theology is that it's supposed to be a secret event. Amen. Praise God. But you notice, amen. Praise God. Over in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, the Bible announced the coming of the Lord with the voice, amen. Praise God, of an archangel. Amen. Praise God. It will not be a silent event, but it will be something, amen. Praise God, that's going to catch every eye. Amen. One portion of scripture tells us that every eye shall see him.
Amen.
So it will not be a secret. Amen. Praise God. Amen. When Jesus Christ comes back to this earth. Amen. Praise God. He will resurrect his saints. Amen. Praise God. But it will not be in secret.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. I do believe when Jesus Christ even was born into this world. Amen. Praise God. The whole of the angelic host praising God. Amen. In the heavens. Amen. Praise God. And the wives, the shepherds, man, praise God. Praise God. They saw, amen, this great event. Amen. Praise God. And went all the way to Bethlehem to praise the name of our God. Amen. Praise God. So the coming of Christ in the beginning was not a secret, and his second coming will not be a secret, but it will be a grand event. Matthew chapter 24, verse 20. Amen. Praise God. As the Lord began to tell his disciples about this hour of temptation that's coming upon the face of the earth. Amen. Praise God. He made it clear unto them that it will not be an secret snatching of God's people from the earth. Amen. To escape this time frame in which it's going to come. Matthew chapter 24, verse 20.
But pray ye that your flight be not in the winter.
Notice he's talking about traveling. He's not talking about a resurrection.
No.
He's not talking about a rapture.
You're traveling.
But
Amen.
He's talking about a traveling time.
Amen.
Pray ye that your flight be not in the
winter,
neither on the
Sabbath
day. So you see what the Lord is talking. He's not
Amen.
Talking to Jews. He is talking to his disciples, those that believe and follow him. He is telling them, you pray.
Amen.
Because this time is going to be so bad. It's going to be so challenging. Amen. Praise God for the people of God. That God is literally telling them, listen, you better be praying.
Yes.
That your time of flight, your time of travel will not be during the winter or on the Sabbath day. Why would Christ even mention the Sabbath day? Amen. Praise God. If he had any intentions of getting rid of it. Amen. For those that are keeping the commandments of God, you understand that during the Sabbath day, amen, praise God, you know you cannot buy nor sell. So we won't be buying no tickets or pumping gas in the car.
Amen.
During this, trying to flee during this great tribulation period. Amen. Praise God. So we want to pray that it doesn't be during those times.
Amen.
Next verse, please.
For then shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time. No, not ever shall be.
Verse 22.
And except those days should be shortened, there should no flesh be saved. But for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened.
So the time is going to be terrible. The time is going to be hard. And but here Christ never mentions about, amen, he is going to take us out of it before it happens. But he says, pray that when it happens, your flight is not during the winter, nor
during the
Sabbath
day.
Amen. Give me Matthew, in the book of Matthew chapter 24. Amen. Praise God. When we begin to read, amen, the beginning of the chapter, his disciples asked him a very important question. Amen. Praise God. And Jesus went out out and departed from the temple, and his disciples came to him for to show him the buildings of the temple. And Jesus said unto them, see ye not all these things? Verily I say unto you, there shall not be left here one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down. And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him proudly, saying, tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming and the end of the world?
Amen.
If we begin to read Matthew chapter 24, you will find that as Christ begins to point out the signs of his coming, he does not mention a rapture prior to the great tribulation.
Amen.
But he speaks of the great tribulation coming prior to the resurrection. So there will be no rapture before the resurrection. In Mark chapter 13, amen, as well as Luke 21, we do not hear God say any of those things. But stand in the book of Matthew 24. Let's continue to read just to make sure that it's not mentioned. Amen. Matthew chapter 24, looking at verse 9.
Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and ye shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake.
Listen to what the scripture is telling us. They shall deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. Notice, Christ does not say that he will deliver or snatch us out before this happens. But he says this is going to happen while we are still here.
Amen.
Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. He is not telling them, I'm going to take you out before that happens. No. You notice it happens while they are still here. Verse 21.
For this shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, no, nor ever shall be.
Now when the disciples asked Christ, what would be the sign of your coming and the end of the world, if Christ had any intention of delivering them before the great tribulation, don't you know Christ would have told them? But yet he tells them all these horrible things that are going to take place upon the earth, including affliction that will be directed at them for his name's sake. He tells them this because he knows he has no intentions on taking them out of this world before the great tribulation. But they have to be here for it. Amen. Praise God. Remember, our God is a mighty God. Amen. He's capable of doing anything. Yes, he can take us out. If he wanted to, he could take the people of God out before the great tribulation. He could. He has that power. But that's not his will. His will is to show Satan in the world, amen, praise God, that they cannot harm his people. That the very gates of hell cannot prevail against his church. This time of temptation that's going to come upon the earth, amen, praise God, God can keep us from it without snatching us out of this earth and taking us over into heaven. Amen, praise God. Go with me to Jeremiah 30, verse 5. Jeremiah 30, verse 5. Amen, praise God. Our Lord promised to keep us and promised to deliver us. Amen, praise God, but it's not by way of rapture. Jeremiah 30, verse 5.
But thus saith the Lord.
Thus says the Lord.
We have heard a voice of trembling,
mm-hmm,
of fear.
Fear.
And not of peace.
Yes.
Ask ye now, and see whether a man doeth travail with child. Wherefore do I see every man with his hands on his loins, as a woman is travail, and all faces are turned into paleness.
All faces are turned into paleness. Go ahead.
Alas, for that day is great.
Mm-hmm.
So that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble,
mm-hmm,
but he shall be saved out of it.
God says that they will be saved out of it. Not saved before it happens, but will be saved out of it. Go to Daniel chapter 7, verse 25. Amen. Praise God. The scriptures speak of expressly, amen, that the saints will be or will have to endure some. Amen. Or some what of Satan's wrath against God's people. Daniel 7:25 tells us.
And he shall speak great words against the Most High.
He shall speak great words against the Most High.
And shall wear out the saints of the Most High.
Shall wear out the
saints of the Most High.
Shall wear out
the saints of the Most High.
Wait a minute. How is he going to wear them out if they've already been taken up into heaven? How are they going to be worn out if they have been raptured out? But the scripture says
that wear out the saints of the Most High.
They're coming out of the saints of the Most High. All right. Go ahead. Is that all the scripture?
And think to change times and laws, and they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the divide of times.
That's 3.5 years. Give me Revelation chapter 13. Verse 5.
He that overcometh, the same shall be clothed in white raiment, and I will not blot out
his Revelation 13, verse 5.
And there was given unto him a mouth speaking great things, and blasphemy and power was given to him to continue 42 months.
Verse 6.
And he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God, to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle, and them that dwell in heaven.
And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and to overcome them, and power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations. So he appoint his wrath unto the people of God. This great tribulation that a lot of people get mixed up, thinking that it is God's wrath, is Satan's wrath. Amen. Praise God, appointed to God's people along with God's wrath upon the world. Listen, God will spare us from the hour of temptation that's coming upon the earth, and he is going to do it. But it's not through a rapture.
Amen.
It's not through a rapture. We serve a mighty God. One that's capable of doing marvelous things. And one of the marvelous things that he's capable of doing is keeping you and I right in the midst of a chaotic situation.
Amen.
Right when Satan thinks he has the best of us, God is able to secure us.
Amen.
The Lord says, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation. Stay tuned. For God is able to keep us, but it's not by way of rapture.
Amen.
God bless you. This is God's truth.